Hi and welcome back. Probably you have already seen my video about exporting IFC 4.3 from Civil 3D. If not, I really recommend you to watch it, also to get an overview about the specifics of the IFC 4.3 and why is actually everyone talking about it right now. In that video, we exported a rail model from Civil 3D, and today we will link that same model in Revit to see what we can do with it. Before we head over to Revit, just a small hint for all the Civil 3D users. Since my last video, there has been a new update to the IFC 4.3 add-in, which now also offers the buttons in the menu, meaning you don't need to use the command line anymore if you don't want to. Just a reminder where to find the IFC updates for your Autodesk products. After logging in with your Autodesk account to manage.autodesk.com, you can simply go to the products updates and filter these using the keyword IFC. This gives you a great overview showing all the recent plugins for Civil 3D and of course for Revit. Now let's open Revit and link our IFC 4.3 file. Please keep in mind that you cannot open IFC 4.3 files in Revit. This is a common misunderstanding, but the link IFC will always give you the latest functionality, as this is what the Revit IFC team is currently actively working on. When linking IFC files, you can always check the import settings first. These are also used for the link, and you can change the category mapping, for example, if needed, and also assign a Revit template to be used when linking IFC. When Revit links an IFC, it creates an IFC.rvt file in the same folder where it stores content of the IFC file in order to be able to load it faster the next time you open the project. If there is no project template selected in the import settings, Revit will use the first template set in your Revit options, which is also the first template in the list when you create a new Revit project. Now let's select our IFC file and link it. This can now take a while depending on your CPU speed. I usually go and grab a coffee. Once the file has been processed, you will see the project in Revit, and if you tap select certain elements, you will also see that they have extended properties which came in from Civil 3D. As IFC 4.3 is still not an official ISO standard, the implementation in Revit is also still quite experimental, and you will notice that all these elements are currently linked as a generic model, and you can't really do something about it. So changing the mapping table at the beginning in the settings won't help about this. What you can do now in Revit is, of course, use the linked model as a reference for the building structures you are designing in Revit, and also include the linked elements in the plan views. You can also annotate all the linked elements, of course, and include their IFC properties. And this is something I would like to briefly show you. As this is a linked IFC, the standard tags that come with Revit won't work. However, when linking an IFC, Revit also creates a shared parameter text file in the same folder, which contains all the IFC properties of your linked file and which can be used to create the custom annotation family. For this, we will choose the standard annotation family template, and when adding the annotation, start adding the shared parameters from the file that was generated upon the linking and which is found in the same folder as your IFC. You can select all parameters you need, and after you insert this family in Revit, you need to set it to be used for the tagging of generic models. Obviously, this is just an example, and probably you will have more complex tags in your projects. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. I would love to have your feedback about how far you have come yourself with IFC 4.3 and if you have any questions. I'm really planning to start doing these videos more regularly again, and I will try to answer as many of your questions there as possible. Thanks and see you!